tool in India. Okay, this tool was developed by Denmark Technical University, and it is now distributed by Quantum under Quantum ATK by this integrated microsystem. Now I request Mr. Harinder to please let us know more about the capability of DFT code, how it works, and how our students can use it in their theoretical calculations. Mr. Harinder, please. Mr. Harinder?
Hello.
Yes, Mr. Harinder.
Yes. So thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone, to joining this session. So I hope you're getting my screen this time.
Yes, screen is there. You can use full screen mode.
All right. Okay. So I hope this is fine, right? Hello? I hope the screen is fine this time, right?
Yeah, please go ahead, Mr. Harinder.
Okay. So let me introduce myself first. My name is Harinder Kumar, and I'm application engineer at Integrated Microsystem. And as sir, I was already explained that what is the ATK Integrated Microsystem is. Actually, we are the sole distributor of this Quantum ATK software in India. So we will see what the Quantum ATK is and how this software is beneficial for your material research as well as the device research. So it is a tool that can be used for the material prediction of the material properties as well as the device characteristic at nano level. Okay, so we will see. So my session consists of two parts. First, some basic understanding what this tool is, and later on quickly I will finish this thing, and later on we will see the demonstration of the tool, and you guys will see that how this Quantum ATK tool, this modeling tool, will be beneficial to predict the material properties that is existing in our environment. And also, you can also predict the properties that is the material which is not even developed. So you can even think of to synthesize the new material. So we can see how this tool is the beneficial for that. So that's why, as you can see, the name of the presentation, or you can say the name of the session, like atomic scale modeling, modeling made easy. So this tool is a very handy tool to model the even very complicated structure. Okay, even complicated structures like nanostructure, crystals, CNT, carbon nanotubes, graphene sheets, double layer graphene sheet, triple layer graphene sheet. So no matter how much complicated structure you have, you will be able to model them. So once you will be able to model the things, then only you will be easily, you can say, go to the level so that you can easily model the properties, like how its electrical properties, how the material, what's the magnetic properties, or you can say the mechanical properties of that, or you can say if we can apply the bias through it, then how the current flow, what's the charge transport and heat transport through the particular material. Okay, so we will see everything in this session. Okay, so let's get started. So as you can see, this one, so we already familiar with this Schrödinger equations. So let me give you some brief idea, like why we have to use the DFT, because everyone know about the Schrödinger equations. So this is equations which can describe the wave function of a quantum mechanical system. Okay, for any system, for any black body type of system that consists of only single electron. Okay, so this is the equation that you have to solve, and you can see it is a sum of infinite series of other periodic function. And if you can solve this equation, you will get the eigenvalues. Eigenvalues means you can get the solution in terms of eigenvalues, and it will give you the energy states. So this is the thing if you want to solve a single electron system, that you can say a hydrogen system that is completely isolated from every other electrons, or you can say that no other force it's applied on it. But the thing is that if we see, okay, fine. Okay, so what happens if we have the many body system? So that's the thing about the single electron system. But But let's suppose if we have a many body system, let's take one example. We have a H2O molecule, let's say one water molecule. Then what we have to do? So for the water molecules, it has, you can say the 10, it's not 10 atoms, it's a 10 electrons. Okay, so it has the 10 electrons, and even 10 electrons have, each electrons have three spatial coordinates per atom. You can say four per electron. Okay, so you can see for the exponential equation, you have to solve the exponential equation will be very much complicated, and it will become a 30-dimensional problem. So the solving such problem is very much painful for people. So, and also it will not give you exact results because the Schrodinger never take into account the forces that taken into account, like the interaction between electron to electron or electron to the nucleus. So in that case, we have to go to the DFT. Like DFT can solve such these many body problems. So what actually the DFT is? So DFT is a computational quantum mechanical modeling method we can use in physics, chemistry, and material science to investigate the properties of many body systems. Okay, so what actually the density function theory is? So the density function theory, it is a two theorems. So first is that if you have the ground state energy, so you can say the ground state energy is directly proportional to the electron density. So it means if you know the electron density of a system, you can actually predict the ground state energy. And ground state energy, if you get the ground state energy, then you will be able to predict the other properties of it as well. That is totally directly related to that. So in the density function theory, we only specifically looking for to calculate the electron density, and accordingly we will calculate the ground state energy. So this is basically a density function theory. And the theorem two is that, like, if the electron density that minimize the electron of overall function is the true ground state energy. So we have to iterate over again and again until we get the minimum ground state energy. So this actually the density function theory is. These are the two terms. And so what this density function theory gives you? So the density function theory can help you to calculate the total energy, forces, electronic structure, and therefore allow computing other properties as well. So the properties like structure relaxations, phase stability, energy difference. You can also predict the phonon dispersion. You can also carry out the mechanical stability. You can find out the mechanical stability and properties, prediction and screening, and also the band structure. So many properties can be predicted using the, like, say, electrical properties, electronic properties, magnetic, or you can say the mechanical properties, even thermal properties as well. So this DFT can provide a reasonable balance between the computational efficiency and accuracy, up to thousands of electrons and hundreds of atoms. So if you have to work over the hundreds of atoms, then DFT is the things that you have to use. So now we learn about what the DFT is and why we have to go through it. So this is the DFT tool, and by this DFT code, you will be able to find out the properties. Now, how to implement this DFT? So implement this DFT, there's so many various tools available in the market that will give you valid results. Like these are the mathematical engines. These are the mathematical engines that solve calculations, that solve the equations for you and find out the properties and predict the properties of the materials. Okay, the software, this Quantum ATK, this atomistic toolkit is one of the software which is available in the market that will be helpful to predict the properties of the material using this density function theory. So this is a very advanced level tool, you can say, because in this tool we will give a very dedicated graphical user interface. So you can use the ATK to calculate the material properties. But before calculating the material properties, the one very big problem that people face is the modeling. So in this tool, you will get a very dedicated virtual neural lab, which is the name of the graphical user interface. You will get, and you will be able to model your structure, no matter how complicated structure you have, no matter if you are working on CNT, graphenes, crystals, you will be able to model it. And if you're able to model it, then you will be able to predict the properties as well. So the first problem that people face is the modeling problem. So we are working very hard to solve this problem for you, and we provide a very dedicated tool, VNL, so that you will be able to model anything that you want to for your work, you can say, for your prediction of materials. So you will be able to predict the properties of any material. And also DFT, and we provide you not just DFT. So in this DFT, there is other calculator engines also available. Let's you can say a semi-empirical calculator and force field calculator. And you will be able to do the molecular dynamics as well. So apart from DFT, you will get the semi-empirical force field and other calculators as well. So according to your need, you will be able to use this tool and proceed your work. So as I said, this DFT can be used for the, you can say, for the analyzing the properties of the material. But in ATK, you will also get one more thing, which is named as an NEGF function. Okay, so apart from DFT, like DFT and also the NEGF, non-equilibrium Green function analysis, which will help you to calculate the transport properties as well, because DFT will not help you to calculate the transport. It will help you to calculate the ground state energy, like you can say the static property. But if you are looking for the charge transport, if you are looking for the heat transport, then quantum ATK will give you freedom to predict that thing as well. You can find out the IV characteristic, you will be able to find out the transport, transmission spectrum, transmission pathway, vibrations, and lot many things that is related to the device level, like nano devices. Various nowadays, where research has been going on nano devices like CNT and graphenes. Okay. So this tool will be helpful to do that simulation cell as well. So this is about the virtual annular. Okay, so this is the virtual lab. It is a graphical user interface for the ATK atomistic toolkit, and it's based on the Python. Okay, it's based on the Python, so it is very easy to learn as well and easy to code as well. If you're working on your own plugins, you will be able to create as well. So there's no such problem that you will be faced in molding your structure. So this is like you will be able to make your plugins or any types of molding, and also after the molding, when you run your calculation, you will be able to visualize your results. You will be able to visualize your results in 3D graphical environment with this, the help of this virtual annular. Okay, so this is virtual annular. You can see the virtual annular can be act as a standalone interface to other codes as well. Yes, I agree. Like virtual annular can be used for the ATK interface, but it also you can also interface to the other codes as well, because some other codes is also available in the market, like JIPA, ORCA, LAMMPS, WASP, and Quantum Expresso. But the thing is that the codes which is other codes like WASP, LAMMPS, Quantum Expresso, they don't have a dedicated graphical user interface. Or even if they have, they don't have that much of functionality to model the structure, to visualize the results. So that freedom we are providing, like if you have the VNL, you can also interface this tool with the other codes as well. So you will be able to easily model it, and you will be able to run your calculation over other codes as well. So this is a thing that we are providing in a brief sense, you can say, like we are giving you like NEGF simulations for the transport, and also it gives you a powerful combination of DFT linear combination atomic orbital. We can provide you the DFT plane wave or virtual crystal approximations, DFT half, Hubbard U, semi-empiricals, tight bending like extended Huckels, lateral coasters, and classical potentials in the same package. So you will get the lot many things in the same package. Okay, so this is something about quantum ATK simulation. So as I told you, like we are providing DFT LCO, we are providing DFT plane wave, semi-empirical, force field. So what's the use of that? The use of that, you can easily clearly see here that in the simulation engine, you can see in the bottom, you can see it's showing you the length in meter, and it's showing at the top, it's showing the atoms, the simulation engines. So accordingly, like DFT is valid up to, let's say, when you have the number of atoms 10 raised to power 4, and plane wave is valid if you have 10 raised to power 3. And if your structure is somewhat bigger, then you have to use the semi-empirical. And if you go somewhat like 10 raised to power 7, then the force field result will be valid. And after that, there is a TCAD field will start. And after that, the SPICE, the circuit simulations will proceed after that. So you can see we cover a very lot, whole range of from, you can say, from the Armstrong level up to micro level, up to TCAD level, like micro level we are cover, like from the Armstrong level, or you can say from the Pico level to the micro level we cover, like using the availability of LCO, plane wave, semi-empirical, and force field on a single package. So in the quantum ATK, what platforms you can work? So in you can see, you will be able to work over the molecules, you will be able to work over the polymers, you will be able to work over the bulk, like crystals or nanostructures, or if you are working with the and surfaces, junctions, interfaces, and apart from that, you will be able to work over the devices as well. Like up to 3 probe devices, you can easily work, and also the surface. And the quantum ATK. So you can see this is about something like quantum ATK. So the software has been used by 500 research groups at leading universities, government labs, companies, and almost 1600 papers have been published worldwide with this ATK tool. And whole list is available on the website. Like if you can go to the website, I will send you the link as well. We'll share the link. And you can see the whole list of the papers that is published. And you can see the people use this tool for the various different applications, because the application area is very large. So you can see you will be able to work with the molecules, crystals, polymers, or you can see the batteries, solar cells, MOSFETs, FinFETs. So now people use this tool for the various applications, you can say. And this, with the help of graphical user interface, ATK is also an ideal tool for teaching the basic concepts like nanotechnology, solid state physics, and metallurgy, because people can easily visualize this. People will be able to model it. And if you can't, because of that, they will be able to run the calculation and see the results. So this is the thing. So this is about the quantum ATK. Now we talk something like what's the workflow here. So as every simulator tool have, the quantum ATK also have its workflow. So you can see, you can initially see the build, compute, and analyze. So this is a complete workflow. So first you have to build your structure in terms of crystals, nanotubes, nanosheets, interfaces, or surfaces. First you have to build it with the use of VNL. Then you have to compute your calculations. You have to compute like what type of calculation you want to perform, like electronic structure, thermoelectric properties, optical properties, mechanical, electron phonon interface, or electron phonon coupling, or transport. So first you have to compute. First you have to build, then compute, and then after that you have to run your calculation and you can analyze. So this is a simple workflow that we use in quantum ATK. This is the GUI for the this is a graphical user interface for the quantum ATK tool. So you can see, this is the thing. I will discuss more about this in the in the demonstration part. That will be more helpful for you. You will see this thing later. And this is something like, this is a device structure. You can see this such type of device structure, very complicated structure, that you can say this is a graphene sheet and have the drain and source. And also at the bottom, you can see the gate and also the dielectric region. So such structure can be made very easily. Okay. And whatever that you made, you have to use the graphical user interface. You have to use the GUI of the software. Whatever you made, everything will be converted into the Python code that you can easily submit on your computer or your machines, like workstation. You can easily convert it or submit for running the calculations. Okay, so this is the, as I already told you, like we will be able to work with the materials devices. So you can see in the left hand side, you can see the material structure, crystal structure, where you can see the periodic boundary. And the right hand side, you will see the device structure that has the semi-periodic boundary. And you can see it has the drain, it has the source electrode, and also the gate all around structure. So such type of structure can easily model it in this quantum ATK software. So simulating semiconductor material properties. So this is like, with this software, you will be able to easily calculate the electronic and mechanical properties, thermoelectric, high-k dielectrics, four materials, 3-5 materials, 2D materials, metallic alloys, or you can see the dynamic processes, interfaces between the materials. So the properties, so many properties you can calculate, like in terms of electrical, optical, thermal analysis, like that. And also these are the properties that is related to the devices, like you will be able to work with the spintronics devices, MRAM, or batteries, or solar cells, or you will be able to find out the transmission function, like IV curve, transmission spectrum, thermal transport, or charge transport. You will be able to work with the MOSFETs, FinFETs, TFETs, a lot more things you will be able to do. And this is the application. These are some of the applications, some more application, but these are not the limits. So you can see these are not the limits. You will be able to work with the graphene, centrifuge, nanotubes, nanowires, and MD simulations, molecular dynamic simulations as well. So, but this is a viewer here, and this is just a functionality of the viewer, because after you're running your calculation, you need some tool to visualize your results. You need some tool to visualize your band structure, to visualize your density state, to visualize your absorption spectrum, or to visualize the spatial visualization of the electron density. So we need some tool. So this is the tool which is available in Quantum ATK, which is named as a viewer, simple. So you can see that it is very high performance, and up to 1 million atoms you can easily visualize. It's up to 1 million plus. And also it has the ISO surface, ISO lines, counter plots. So you will be able to easily plots the ISO surface plots or ISO line plots and counter plots in this viewer Quantum ATK. And also you can see, if you run the MD trajectory, or if you run the device optimization or crystal optimization, so in most of the tool you will be only able to get the last image, like what happened afterwards, the image after the optimization. But in this tool you can also able to save the trajectory, so you can actually see how your crystal behave, how your material behave, how your device behave when you applied some stress, when you applied some strain, like something like that. Like you can actually see, you can actually feel the things that is going on. So that tool is very good to the learning purposes. Okay. So, and you can also export in terms of GIFs, all those things. Now job manager. So you can see this is also one more tool which is available in Quantum ATK. I want to add one more thing is like such calculations as we see the screen injury. We have one Schrodinger equation, solving Schrodinger equation for single electron. It takes so much calculation you have to perform. But here we are working on, let's say, thousands of atoms. So the calculation is still expensive, so much expensive, computation costly. So in this case, we need some resources like hardware resources, like processors, RAM. So in this, and we provide the functionality that you will be able to run your calculation over your cluster machine as well, over your workstation. So let's suppose you want to model, but people don't want to work over the cluster. They want to work over their very simple, you can say, very sleek monitor, which is very easy to handle, or you can say the very easy to handle monitor or laptop. They want to work, but they don't want to work over the cluster, or you can say they don't want to work over the cluster. So what Quantum ATK is provide is that you will be able to model your structure. You will be able to model your structure over your personal laptop or your personal PC. And then after that, you can easily run your calculation over the cluster as well. And you just only need a proper connection, SSH connection between the client to the server machine. That's it. You don't have to do many things. You don't have to worry about the login things. Everything can be set up by this job manager, and it will perform everything. It will submit your job. It will take track of your job status. Then after the simulation has been performed, when the simulation has been finished, it will give you back results back to your PC. So this is very a good tool, job manager, to run your calculations, and it will make your life very. So what type of structure can be modeled in this software? So as we already said, we will be able to work over the junctions, interfaces, surfaces. A lot more things can be modeled here, and we will see the in demonstration part as well. So you will be able to work over the devices, like some traditional quantum isolated molecules. Some are working on the periodic system, but in ATK you will be able to work over others' complicated structure as well. That's why we are make it to work over the devices with the user. Okay, so this is one plugins which has been added in 2018 version, earlier version. So this is a LOA, so creating such LOAs, it's very easy, like SQS type of SQS LOA. So let's suppose you are working on aluminum gallium nitride. Let's suppose gallium nitride is there, and you want to work on the aluminum gallium nitride. So such type of LOAs you can easily create, and you can predict the properties of those LOAs. Okay, so now let's talk about what are the benefits. These are some of the brief benefits why we have to use this Quantum ATK software. So this software can be used, like, first, the study of the materials. And whatever study, like you can easily compute the electronic, optical, thermal, magnetic, mechanical, electron photon coupling, piezoelectric, thermoelectric, and other material properties of the nanostructures, bulk materials, and surfaces. And also, you will be able to work over the devices, and you will be able to calculate the transport analysis, nanoelectronics, IV curve, transistor, spin transfer torque, mobility. So many things you can calculate on the devices as well. So let's suppose this is one example. People nowadays facing problems in the TCAD simulations because they are working on the TCADs, let's say solar cells, LED, and they want to import new materials. Let's suppose a very new material is the, let's say, perovskite solar cells. But people nowadays, they're not able to find out the properties of that. So if you use the software, you will be able to predict the properties. You will be able to calculate all the properties that has been required by the TCAD simulator tool. So you can predict those properties, you can calculate in quantum ATK, and you can export in TCAD simulation as well. So this is the benefit. This is also one benefit here, that you can also predict the properties of the new material. So you can be able to use those new material in your device applications as well. Okay, so this is the thing. And also, you will be able to work over the electrochemical processes, lithium ion, or lithium air batteries. And also we provide you a very powerful combination of graphical user interface and the Python scripting. Okay, so the working here is very easy. If you're not very familiar with the Python scripting, graphical user interface is the best option for you. And we provide the complete package that consists all the functionality that is available in Quantum ATK over the graphical user interface. You don't have to compromise with any of the functionality if you don't know the Python. And also, for sure, if you use the graphics, you can say that simulation tool, some modeling tool, it will decrease your R&D cost. Because if you're working experimentally, and for a particular experiment, you have to give the hundreds of trials to reach one result. But if you use a simulation tool, if you use some molding tool, so you will be able to predict, you will be able to see like if you are going in the right direction or wrong direction. So for sure, it will decrease your trials. So it will also reduce your R&D cost if you use the modeling tool, and that's the benefit. So system requirement, our software will work over both, like we provide the Linux binary over the Linux as well as the Windows. And we are working to give you the Mac OS binaries as well. We're working on. Okay, so these are some of the applications. We already discussed most of the things here. And this is the more things like semiconductors, batteries, and solar cells, which is available. And you can able to work with this tool. Because the semiconductor industries, battery industries, solar cell industry, they're already using this software. Because in solar cells also, if you want to find out the phonon, like a phonon interaction, then you have to use such tools that can help you. Okay. So now this time I want to show you like what are the computable characteristic you can calculate, like what are the properties you can calculate. This is the list. This is the direct calculation direct analysis that you can perform, like band structure, chemical potentials, effective band structure, fat band structure, electron localization function, electrostatic potential, fat band structure, or you can say the forces, ST-ST states, and the next IV curve, mobility, phonon, projectors. So these are the, or you can say the vibration mode. So these are the calculations, or these are the analysis that is available in the Quantum ATK that you can perform directly. And this is not the limit. You can also run your calculation, and you can also find out the properties that is not available, but are directly related to some other analysis. So let's take one example. Let's suppose you didn't see anything here, something like resistance and conductance, but we will be able to find out, because if you have the IV curve, if you have the transmission spectrum, then we will be able to find out the conductance, and we will be able to find out the resistance as well. Same one example, you can see here we have elastic constant. We have the elastic constant, but it is a mechanical property. So if you have the elastic constant, you can easily predict, you can easily extract the data for the Young modulus, Poisson ratio, or shear modulus, and other types of properties that is related to those. So these are not the limits. These are the calculation that is available directly. Okay, so these are the some of more advanced analysis that is available, like molecular dynamics, optimized geometry, dynamical metrics, charge point effect, Monte Carlo simulations, time step forced by Monte Carlo simulations. So these are the things that, like, these are the advanced analysis that quantum ATK provides. Okay, so now I will show you the live demonstration of Synopsys quantum ATK software. Okay, so so I hope you're getting my screen this time. This is a screen for the quantum ATK software. Fine. Okay, so this is the screen for the quantum ATK software. And from now, we will start our demonstration part. Okay, so this is a software. And you can see the software has so many tools at the left-hand side. So these are the tools that will be helpful for us to for modeling the structure, for creating the script, for visualizing the structures. So I will demonstrate you, or I will show you how you can use this tool to do your work. So let's see what are the functionality here. So we can see here builder, we can see here the scripter, custom scripter, editor, jobs, viewer, and database. Okay, so we will see one by one everything. So this is the builder. So if I click on the builder, you can see, you will see one screen builder, as you can easily suggest, as you can easily predict the name, like builder, it's for the building. So building your structure, whatever the structure you have, even if you're working with the molecules, crystals, devices, materials, or nanostructures. So you have to use this platform to build your structure. So it will be act as a nano lab. Okay, so that's why we called it as a virtual nano lab. So it is your nano lab here. So you can use this tool to model. You just have to model in the builder. You just have to model your structure. And we have other tools like scripter. This scripter will be useful to making script, like a script, like what type of analysis we want to perform. Let's suppose I working on single crystal, and for the single particular crystal, I want to calculate the band structure. So that thing I will define in my scripter. And we have the custom scripter as well. So custom scripter, as we already see in the presentation, I told that this software can be interfaced with the other tools like BAS, Quantum Express. So this custom scripter will be useful to those other codes. And this is the editor. It is like any IDE, or you can say the notepad where you will edit your script, and we will see how to do that. And this is the job we see in the presentation, a job manager. So this is the thing that job manager will do. And this is the viewer for the visualizations. And this is the database. And we will see how we can use this database. And actually, this is the online database library, cryptography open database, and material function. And we will see how to use that and how to import our material. So let's take one example. Let's take one thing here, like, and this is the builder here. Let's see the functionality of the builder. Okay. So you can see this is right now it's empty. So in the top, you can see these are some of the tools that is available. Okay, these are the tools that is available, like simple tools like selection tools, measure tools, move tools. So these are the tools that is available, and also the tools available at the right hand side, like bulk tools, coordination tools. So you can see these tools will be helpful to model our structure, to model our structure. This tool will be helpful. These basic tools and advanced tools, and we can do many things here. So let's take one example, how to start our work. So first we have to add, and you have option of new configuration from files and database. So I'm heading towards the database, and let's take one example here. Okay, so let's take one example, simple example, and I'm taking SIC. Okay, silicon carbide, and as you select the silicon carbide, you see the two structures here, FCC and hexagonal. So accordingly, according to your requirement, you can select, and you can see the description here along with the configuration. So this is a, actually this is silver here. So I have to select here. So it will add. So now you can see the description for SiC and also the configuration for silicon carbide. So after, when you select, you have to select first and then you have to add. Okay, so I click on the add. You can see the crystal has been added in Quantum ATK version lab. You can see version lab space here. So, and this is, you can say, if you hover your mouse, you can say this is the silicon, and you can also see the coordinates and index. This zero is the index, and also you can see this is carbon. So silicon, this is a silicon carbide structure. So let's say one, what we can do, we will, I'm interested to find out the pen structure. I'm interested to find out the electrical structure, or you can say the band structure of this silicon carbide, how it's behave. What's its behavior? Until and unless I can't see that the band structure, I didn't know that what's the actual the behavior. So to predicting the properties, I have to calculate the band structure, or you can calculate the other properties like DOS is there, or if you want to predict the optical properties, we can heading towards calculate the optical properties or the piezoelectric, whatever the our requirement is, accordingly we can proceed. So let's see one few of the things. Let's suppose this is one crystal, and this is a simple crystal. Let's suppose you are working on the supercell. If you are working on supercell, then there is option of bulk and there is option of repeat. So you just have to repeat. Let's suppose you have to repeat. You have to include a number of atoms, large number of atoms. So you can easily repeat it, and the number of atoms increase. And also, if you want to see the basic information, there is an I button here, and you can see configuration information like this number of atoms is available, and FCC lattice type, and this is the lattice constant here because we increase the size of crystal, and this is the primitive vector, reciprocal vector. So some basic information we get from here. So you can see the undo and redo button. I'm interested on this simple pristine crystal. So as you can see, I just import from database, and now I want to predict one properties, which is, let's say, band structure. So what I have to do, I have to navigate from here to the script generator. You can see that it is already bold, so you don't have to worry about it. So you have to just click on the bold option. So as I select, you can see it is already added here. So what you have to do, you have to add your calculator. So as we already see, what's the DFT? DFT helps us to calculate the properties, band structure, and all those things. So these are the DFT that you will be applying in this section.
Anandji, sorry to interrupt, but we are not getting your scripted screen.
Okay.
Scripted screen is not getting. We are just getting your ATK homepage.
Okay, you didn't get even builder as well, I guess.
Yes.
So actually, I understand the problem. Actually, it's not sharing the complete my.
Yes.
Sharing one application.
Right.
Okay. No problem. I will demonstrate one more time. No problem.
Okay.
I will share. Thank you so much. Okay, so I hope this is time you getting my screen, builder. Yes. Builder screen.
Now we are getting.
Okay. So it's okay. So this is the builder screen, and I will show you one more time how to import the structure. So you can see these are the several options is available, like these are the simple structures, simple. You can see the simple tools like selection tools, matching tools, or you can see move tool or molecular builder. So these are some basic tools that is available, and at the right hand side you can see these are some of the advanced tools. So by these tools, we can do many things. We can do many things, like we can work over the molecule structure, even the complicated structure. So according to our requirement, we have to use it like we work over the paint. So it's like a paint here. So it's like a paint. You have to, according to our requirement, we can select our tool and we work over it. So this is something like a paint. So first we have to import our structure. So first you have to plus, and then you have to go to the database. So you just have to search here. So you can see the database list is huge. So many materials is available. This is the complete material list. So many materials is available here. And this is the materials that is particular related to the crystals. And we have database for the molecules as well. So this is the molecules database. The list is huge. And also we have fullerenes. Okay, so this is the database for the fullerenes, and accordingly we zeolite structure as well. So if you are working on the zeolite structure, you can import your structure for me. So right now I'm only interested to find out the band structure of SIC. So what I have to do, I have to select the database, crystal database. I have to search my material SIC, and then it's showing you the two configurations, hexagonal and FCC. Any configuration you can choose in which you are interested. So I'm interested in this FCC structure. So as you select, you can see some of the description here. The description, like what's the lattice constant and what's the symmetry informations and atom positions. And this is the configuration. So if you're satisfied with that, you can just add. So if you add, that thing will be added in your builder. So as you can see, the thing is added in your builder. So you have to go to the bulk tool. And in the bulk tool, you can see the repeat. So I will repeat it. Let's suppose if you want to work on some large number of atoms, so you just have to give numbers here. Let's suppose 2 and 2 and 2. I want to repeat two times in A direction, B direction, and C direction. So then you have to give the number 2 to 2 and apply. So you can see the number of atoms increase. So like this way, you will be able to work over different types of structures and all. Like if you want to repeat your structure, or you have option to merge, or you have option to stretch if you want to stretch your cells. Okay. So we will see this thing as well. So right now I'm only interested to find out the band structure of this SIC, simple SIC. So this is my one purpose here. So I go to the plus, then database, I select my data. From the database, select this silicon carbide. And then right now I want to find out the band structure. So what I have to do, I have to go to the script generator. And this is the script generator. Okay. So I share my screen for the script generator this time. Fine. So I hope you're getting my screen this time for the script generator. So this is the screen for the script generator. This is the screen for the, this is a screen for the script generator. You can see this bulk is already been added. This is the bulk that we had added from the builder. We work over the builder and it is added in script generator. Now you have to select the calculator engines. The calculator engines we discussed before, like DFT. We discuss about DFT, and there are several DFT available, several types of DFT available, like LCO DFT. We have plane wave DFT as well. So there is some other DFT is also available. So accordingly, according to a requirement, as you already see, like what type of how, because according to a requirement, we have to select the calculator engines. Like are we selecting the semi-empirical, force field, plane wave, because DFT is, let's say plane wave DFT, it is valid up to hundreds of atoms, and LCO DFT validates up to thousands of atoms. Then we have to work over the semi-empirical that can go beyond that, and then force field that can go beyond over that. So they have their own, you can say, the pros and cons accordingly. Because if you are working on the plane wave, for sure you will get the more accurate results, but also you have to provide the more computational resources. Okay, so you have to work. Means you have to work according to, like, but are you providing proper resources accordingly? Like if you are looking for the more accurate results, then you have to give you the more accurate, or you can say the more number of resources. It's something like you have to make a trade-off. You have to make a trade-off between your accuracy level and your resources that you are providing. Okay, so I'm taking LCO calculator here at this time to calculate the band structure. So let's add. So it is added here. So let's see what are the options available in LCO. If you double click on this, so you can see this option, this windows will open up. So in this window, you can see there are several options is available, several quick settings is available. So what are these settings is? Okay, so these are some, like suppose you're working on one mathematical equations. So in this mathematical equation, we have to predict, we have to assume something, we have to give some constant values and all those things. So DFT is also one mathematical equations. So for the solving the equations, solving a particular equation for a particular material, we have to define our DFT. So this is something like this. So you can see with the spin, like you have to define a spin. Like suppose you are working on some polarized material, then you have to select the polarized here. If you're working on some non-polarized material, then you have to select the unpolarized. It is something like that. Then exchange correlations, like what type of exchange correlations, like are you working on LDA, GGA, meta-GGA? So these are different exchange correlation that is available. And accordingly, your results will vary. Because that, as we can see, the ground state energy is directly proportional to the electron density. And these GGA, meta-GGA, or LDA will affect your calculation or affect your function that calculate the electron density. So for sure, it will affect your results as well. So accordingly, you have to select the pseudo-potentials. These different pseudo-potentials are available and basic sets. And this is the K points there, like 11, 11, 11 K points. So K points is something like that. We are sampling our structure. So this is a crystal. You can say this is a crystal that have some dimensions. Some have some dimensions, let's say 4 Armstrong in A direction, 4 Armstrong in B direction, and 4 Armstrong in C direction. So the K points is something like that. It will sample the structure. It's not sample the real vector. It sample the reciprocal vector actually. The crystal have some reciprocal vector and it sample that thing. So I want to show you one more thing before proceeding there so that you can easily correlate the words the reciprocal is. So I will show you, I will share my screen, builder screen. Okay. So now you have my builder screen and let's suppose I want to see this Brillouin zone. Okay. So this is the Brillouin zone here and actually it is a reciprocal space. Okay, when you sample structure, this is the root here. These are different roots available. So accordingly, we will find out the band structure of this root. Okay, so what it did, these K points will sample these reciprocal space. Okay, in theory, or you can say in theoretical, we have to take the K points infinite number of times, like infinite number. The numbers is infinite in theory for these K points, but we can't go up to that. So that's why we have to optimize it. We have to optimize, like either we have to go 11, 11, 11, or 17, or 11, or you can say 13, 13, according to the structure. As the size increase, the K points decrease because we are working on the over the reciprocal space. So let's suppose we have 10 Armstrong, A of 10 Armstrong. So if we work on the reciprocal, so it should be 1 over 10. And let's suppose we have in real space, we have crystal of 5 Armstrong. So if we make a reciprocal of that, it will act as a, or it will give you value of 1 by 5. So for sure, 1 by 5 is greater than 1 by 10. So accordingly, if we increase our structure in real space, in reciprocal space it will decrease, and accordingly we have to give the lesser number of K points. So accordingly we have to define such things, and also these some basic settings that you have to do just to run your DFT calculations. And also I want to show you a few things like LCO basic sets. So what are the basic sets? So basic sets is the like potential curve. So for silicon, because we are working on silicon and carbon. Okay, so as I told you, DFT is a type of equation where you have to give the several values of assumptions and constants. And for this silicon, because we are working on silicon and carbon, so we have to give some values for the silicon and carbon is. So these are the values, these are the basic set, these are the functions, these are the wave functions that we are providing in our DFT equations for these silicon and carbons. So we can easily predict that it goes up to 4 angstrom. Okay, and these are the values. Okay. Okay, so let's suppose we are done with our calculation, we are done with our settings, we are done with our settings of LCQ setting. Now we have to add our analysis. So you can see these are the calculator options. Then you have the initial state, like if you are interested to give the spin, or this is the option for optimization. I don't want to optimize the structure because of the lack of time. So I will just directly run our calculations. So you can see in the analysis type, you can see several options is available, like band structure, plot state, chemical potential. So accordingly, the list is huge, as we see in our demonstration part, as that presentation part as well. There's several things like Raman spectrum is available, also spin transfer torque, polarizations, photocurrent, second harmonic generation susceptibility, total energy. So many things, so many analysis is available. So let's suppose right now I'm only interested to find out the band structure first. So first I have to select the band structure, and this is the thing, I added the band structure. And if you open the band structure, you can see the Willen zone is already added. And if you want to change it, you can change, or if you want to change, these are some internal settings that you have to do according, so that you will get your results according to your requirement. I don't want to change, I'm looking into to go to the default one. So this is the result file name. I don't want to change anything here. And then I'm going to the, okay. So first, before proceeding to the job manager to running my calculation, I want to first show you the script. So as I already told you, this is a software which is working on the graphical user interface as well as the Python programming. So you can see, as you can see, we model our structure, we define our calculator, we define the band structure. So everything is converted into the Python script. You can see this is a Python, it's a Python script. You didn't need anything. You can see this is the latest elements. So everything is defined here. As you work over the graphical user interface, everything is defined. Now this script will be run over the machine. So I'm going to run this like band structure. You can see the band structure, and it will save your results in terms of description, like this. Okay, so this is my structure. I'm heading towards the job manager to run my calculation. Okay. So now you have to save. First, you have to save your script. I'm saving my script. I hope you're getting my screen this time. Or no problem, I will share it. And I will check if it is shared or not. So I'm saving the script. And after saving,
it is shared. You may please
go ahead. So now you have the option of job manager here. Okay, so I'm sharing the job manager screen. So now you have my job manager also. So in this job manager, you have to select like how you want to submit your script. So here you have to define your resources. I'm just very fast submitting it, and it will start run. That's not an issue. So I will not wait for it. I will proceed for the next step. Let it be run. It will take, let's say, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Yeah, because it is a very simple calculations, just a band structure for those two crystals. So it will not take much time, just 1 minute or 2 minutes it will take. So let it be run, and we will see a few more functionality that Quantum ATK provides. So I'm sharing my screen for the builder one more time. Okay, so I hope you're getting my screen this time as well for the builder. So let's see, this is basically like, this is a thing that we are working on crystals and we can move on. So let's take one complicated structure. what happens if you're working on the complicated structure? So complicated structure, let's say carbon nanotubes or graphene sheets or double layer graphene sheets like this. So for that, you can see the option is available from the plugins. So for in Quantum ATK, the Quantum ATK, the plugins is already available for the user. The plugins is already available in terms of, you can say if you're working on the nanotubes. So you just have to select the nanotube here and you have to define your lattice. Like, let's suppose I'm designing like these lattice, I'm indices I'm defining here, 5x5. And if you're working on the double layer, you can enable this as well. Or triple layer, you can enable this as well. But right now I'm only interested in single layer. So you can select the 5x5 and you can see the preview. Okay. So it will show you the preview. If you are interested with that or you want to change, you can go to the preview one more time or you can just build it. So if I'm okay with this 5x5, I want to see the results. Okay. So this is a carbon nanotube, one single unit carbon nanotube. But carbon nanotube, as you can see, it's a tube. So it has some length. So what we have to do, we have to repeat the structure again. So you can see the length is in C direction. So now this time I will not increase in A and B direction. I will make it as 1.1, but in C direction, I will increase. Let's make it 15. Okay, and apply. So you can see, we make a very beautiful carbon nanotube here. Okay, or you can easily visualize this. And if you are eager to know about the size or length and all those things, you can go to the this information button. And you can see it's around, let's say, 3.6 nanometer carbon nanotube. Okay. Fine. So this way you can create your carbon nanotube as well. Same way, I will show you how to work over the carbon nanotube, and we will do some of the modification in that, carbon nanoribbon. So let's suppose I'm interested to create a zigzag nanoribbon. Okay, atom wide, 10 atom wide, or you can say make it 8 and preview and build. And same again, I will repeat it 15 times. Okay, so now we have carbon nanoribbon. Okay, so I will show you some of the modification that you can do here. So let's suppose this is a selection tool, simple. Now let's see what this measure tool does. So let's suppose you are interested to measure the distance between single two carbon atoms. So you can see you just have to select this atom, second atom. So it will give you the distance. So accordingly, you can find out the distance between two atoms. And if you are interested to find out the angle, so how to make angle? For angle, we need the 3 points. So this is the 1 point, this is the second point, and this is the third point. Okay. So for angle, we need the 3 point. And so you can see this is 120 degree. Okay. And also accordingly, you can add different, like 60, 36.5. So you can measure, and also dihedral angle. So you will be able to find out the plane angle as well. So that functionality will be helpful sometime when you want to measure. And also this is a move tool. Move, like if you want to move your structure right and translatory motion or rotatory motion. So that will be helpful. This move tool will be helpful in that case. So let's quickly see one example of rotatory motion. So let's suppose you want to rotate it, let's say 45 degree, 35 degree, or any rotation. So this is the center of rotation. We just have to decide the center of rotation, and you can click on that, and then you can just rotate. So accordingly, you can rotate in any direction, any like translatory motion is support, and also translatory motion, rotatory motion, and something like that. So this tool will be useful if you're working on some complicated structure and you want to combine two geometry, like you have to combine two model, like you want to put one carbon nano ribbon into one carbon nano tube or something like this. So in that case, the translation, so you can see the move tool will be much helpful, and it will ease your work. And also, this is You can say this is a carbon nanotube. And let's suppose I want to change this atom. I want to make a doping. Okay. So because doping is a very thing that we have to mostly very frequently we do. So let's suppose this is a carbon atom and I want to replace this carbon atom with one nitrogen atom, or you can say the boron atom or silicon atom, any atom. So what you have to do, you just have to select it and you have to go this silicon type, like this is actually the symbol for silicon and actually it's a periodic table. So you have to select any elements that you are interested. So I'm interested on, let's say, nitrogen. So I just have to select the nitrogen and you can see it just replaces this carbon with the nitrogen. Very easily, you don't have to do much. And same way, you can also, if you are interested, to create the vacancy in between. So you just have to select and go to the delete button, it will delete. Okay, so like this way, you can easily create the vacancies as well. Okay, and also trap, sometimes we have to make a trap, or you can say the interstitial doping, something like that. So in that case, what we have to do, you can just select all the atoms here. Okay, and there is an option of centroid available here. So if you click on that, it will add one atom at the center. And let's suppose right now it is a carbon atom. And if we want to change it, we just have to select, go to the periodic table and change to some other, let's say silicon. So it will change to silicon. Okay, so this is the thing here, actually. Okay. So these are some of the tools that is available and will be helpful for you. So let's see if our results generated or not. So in the job manager, you can see the results has been, I will share my screen for the job manager again. Okay. So you can see now the results have been calculated for this band structure, SIC band structure. And at the end, it will give you some of the information, like how much time it takes for the loading, the modules, diagonalization. So it's some tasks that has been performed while doing the calculation. So it takes around 2 minutes and 54 seconds. So across 30 minutes, 3 minutes it takes. And it totally depends on your machine, because I'm running on my laptop. So as laptop is not much functional for these types of calculations, so it takes much time, 3 minutes. So you can see, if I will show you some thing here, like you can see this is the log file. And it will start the DFT calculations here, and also the processors. And you can see it defined the SCF, self-consistent loop information, and it will give you the how much memory it requires, like 29 MB. So this type of data sometimes helpful to rectify the problem, because sometimes you face some problems while running the calculations. So if you don't have the data, if you don't have the insights of these calculations, you're not able to rectify it. So such type of log file will be very much helpful. So you can see this is we defined the K point grid as 11, 11, 11. And if you multiply it, it will something more than 1,000. But you can see the number of irreducible K points is 666. So what is did, if you multiply 11 into 11 into 11, so it will be, the node point will be more than 1,000, or you can say the more than 1,100. So it will reduce the K points. It will reduce according to the symmetry. Okay, so that's why it's giving 666, and the number of storage requirement and all those things. After that, it will start calculating the density matrix, and again decreasing. It will iterate it. It will iterate like one iteration, two iteration, three iteration, until it will not reach the tolerance value. And we define the tolerance value 10 or minus 5. This is the tolerance value that we can accept. So it goes up to 10 raised to power minus 5. So you can see as it goes here, and it shows the calculation is converged this time. This delta E value and delta H. So both are 10 raised to power minus 5 less than. So in this case, it shows the calculation is converged and it gave you the result. So this is the actually thing that is performed at the background. It will solve the calculation and it will run the iterations until it will not get converged. Okay, so let's see. Let's see the results. Let's suppose we calculate the band structure. So how it's look like? And okay, fine. Just okay. So I will share screen one more time. Okay, fine. So I hope you're getting my screen, main window, Coltemetic. Okay, so I shared it. So you can see in the main window, you can see some of the results. So these are the files that is available, like .sdfi, SIC, log, and pbind. So this is the input file, this is log file, and this is the output file. So visualizing the results, we just have to click tick here. And you can see the results has been added here, and this is the band structure. So as you have just have to select the band structure, and you have to search here. Okay. Okay, so you can see the band structure analyzer is active here. So you just have to select the band structure analyzer, and it will give you a very good band structure for this SIC crystal. So you can see this is the band structure that we calculated for SIC. You can see the direct band gap is 4.54 and indirect band gap is 1.3. And accordingly, we can extract more insight from this data, like is it a direct band gap material or is it a indirect band gap material, what's the effective mask of the mass, or is it a metal or semiconductor or insulator, like this more insight we can extract from this band structure. Something. Okay. So we have a lot more things available, like if you want to save the plot or this is the tool editor. So we can discuss that thing later on. So it is just the thing, like you can calculate the band structure like this. So let's proceed for one more example and calculate something like some electronics, you can say the optical property. So we already see the electrical property. So I'm in midway between the this one, like how to make the vacancies or how to make the vacancy or how to make the doping in that. Okay, so we already see this thing, and let's see what are the options available in Builder. These are the bulk tools or coordinates. So we will see. Let's run one more calculation because it will take like 2 or 3 minutes. So in the meantime, we will run one calculation, and then in the meantime, we will see the more functionality. So I want to calculate, I want to calculate the optical properties. I'm interested to calculate the optical properties. So I'm searching one optical material. Okay, so I'm searching one optical material. I hope you're getting my screen. Okay, so you have to search here. Okay. Okay, so I'm looking for molybdenite MOS2. So same way as I selected the SIC, I'm selecting again molybdenite, and you just have to double click it and it will add it. So this is a molybdenite crystal, and I want to find out the optical spectrum, like absorption or dielectric constant, such type of properties I want to evaluate. So what you have to do, you just have to drag the crystal here, and now it's up to you. Do you want to model it? Do you want to convert into the SIC, or you work in the 2D material? If you're working on the 2D material, then you, because right now it is a 3D. You can see right now it is a 3D material, and if you're working on the 2D material, then you have to give some sufficient vacuum in upper and down, like upper and upside and down. So you have to give some sufficient vacuum. So right now I'm looking for on the optical analysis. So I'm doing navigate to the script generator one more time, and then I will share my screen for the script generator. Wait. Okay, so this is the screen for the script generator, and accordingly, one more time. Okay, and we can see in the LCO, like this time the sampling has been done like 10, 10, and 3. You can see as the size of the C increase, the number of K points available in the C direction decrease, because as I already told, like if you increase the length, the real space, it will decrease the length in the reciprocal space. So it will did in 10, 10, 3. 10, 10, and 3. So I will go to the again analysis one more time, and then I'm looking for optical spectrum. So I recur mobility, optical spectrum. Okay, fine. So you can also search here as well. OK, Okay, so you just have to search the optical. It will give you the optical spectrum. Okay, so I'm running my my calculation. Again, job manager, same procedure that we followed for that. If we followed for the SIC, same procedure I'm doing here. Okay, so now it's start running calculation at the job manager. And we will start, we will see more functionality that is available in the builder. Okay. So we share my screen for the builder. Okay, so this is the builder available here. So let's see one more functionality. We already see this doping and all those measuring and thing. So let's see what are the options available at this side, this right hand side option. So you can see this is the builder option available. So this is a Heuzler alloy, isohedron, nanostructure, interface builder. So let's take one example of interface, because most of the people who are working on the heterostructure, people who are working on the heterostructure, they have to make an interface, like strike interface between different materials. Or if someone is working on the devices, they are mostly working on the heterostructures for structures and the layer for different layers. So in that case, we have to use this interface builder functionality. So let's take one example. I will take two materials, very well known material. First is gold, okay, and second is, so I'm taking the gold. So gold is added and I'm taking silver. Okay, so I'm taking two materials here, gold and silver, and I'm interested to make an interface between these two materials. So what we have to do next? So right now you can see this is a bulk configuration. This is a one single bulk configuration. You can see the crystal. So you can also make an interface between the two bulk group. Two bulk structure, this is not a problem. It's not a problem. But if you cleave the surface, that will be more helpful, because if you make an interface, it should be cleave. It should be cleave, let's say 100 direction, 111 direction, some Miller indices. Then accordingly, you will get a well-defined interface between two materials. Okay, so you can see you have to define the Miller indices. Okay, so you can see this transparent, or you can say the blur type of plane. So actually this is the surface that has been cut for 100, and as you can see, if I change this to 111, the surface, this will be the surface that has been cut. So it will cut in this direction. So accordingly, I'm right now I'm only interested in 100 direction, and I'm going to the next. And here you have to define, are you looking for the electrode, or you can say that you are looking for the periodic or non-periodic. If you're looking for the non-periodic, it will add the vacuum here. And if you're looking for the periodic, it will remove the vacuum. And you just have option here to define the thickness. So you have to increase the layers like this. Okay, so I'm interested in such layers like this much of surface and 100 direction surface. I'm done with my part and I added. So this is how I cleave my surface for gold 100. Same way, I repeat the same procedure for the silver as well. So what I have to do, I have to go again to the surface cleave. Okay, so I hope I didn't share my screen for I hope you're getting my screen for this surface cleave.
Yes, we are getting.
Okay, fine, thank you. So this is the surface cleave option, and again, see, I will see the do the same thing, 100 direction of the this surface, 100 direction for this silver, and I'm repeating the same procedure. Next, and then I'm just increasing the thickness, let's say this much, and then finish. So now we have two 100 structure. I want to make an interface so that it will act as a heterostructure. So there's the option of interface here. You don't have to do much. You just have to drag one in the first block, and the second one in the second block. You just have to do that much. And the software will automatically calculate the energy, interface energy, and it will give you the results. So we just have to wait for some time. So you can see now you have the structure. It is an interface between gold and the silver. And if you can clearly look over the interface builder here, over my mouse, that there's a strain of 0% on the first one and a strain of 0.12% on the second one. So it's accordingly, like if you interface the gold 111 and silver 111, this much of a strain you will get over the silver. But we are getting on the second one because we have defined the settings here in our setting block. You can see the setting, like here you can see the straining method. Okay, so in the straining method, there is an option available like strain on the second surface, or if you want the strain on the first surface, you can select this one, or if you want strain on both the surface, so you can get the, so according to your requirement, you can select the options. So it is something like that. Okay, so it is something like that. If you want to strain only on the second one, so your gold surface, your first one will be stained that, and the second one we will try to align according to the configuration of the second one. Right now we are only getting 0.12 because the structure is similar, more or less it is similar. But if you take the different type of structures, that's different alignment of the atoms, so in that case you will get the lot more large strain. In that case, I guess. So if you are interested in that, if you want to increase the length or decrease the length, you can do from here, or you can just create it. Okay, so now we have interface of gold and silver. So I'm just checking if I were okay. So I will share my screen for the job manager one more time. Okay, so in this case, you can see the results is finished in just 5 minutes. For optical spectrum, you can see this is the optical spectrum, it is finished. Okay, so again the calculation has been converged and Fermi level it's calculated this much. Fine, so let's see how the optical spectrum look like. So I will share my main screen from here. Okay, so now you have a screen. So you can see the more results has been added. So I'm interested only on SDF5, so I will untick other. So we have this molybdenite.sdf5 as well. So you just have to select, you have to just select from here and then click molybdenite. So you can see more optical spectrum available, and first is the bulk configuration. And now we have to search for the optical spectrum. Okay, so we have optical spectrum analyzer available here. So I just have to select the optical spectrum analyzer from here. Okay, fine. So. Okay, so this is the optical spectrum analyzer, and you can see this is the energy and absorption. This is the absorption graph, and this is the tensor, because we have in molybdenite we have a crystal, and in crystal it has a surface like xx surface, xy surface, xz surface. So at the different surface, because it's different surface, how much is the absorption and how much is the refractive index. So I'm interested to see these things in terms of wavelength, let's say. So you can also change. You can see this is the visible region, and that much is your wavelength. And you can also, if you are only interested to see somewhat, let's say ultraviolet region or infrared region, or ultraviolet to infrared, so you can change lengths. We have to change the length actually. So this is x-axis, y-axis. Okay, y-axis, and I'm changing the parameters. Okay, I have to change the limit actually. Okay, this is lower limit, this is upper limit. Fine. Let's try to change this one. instead of wavelength, let's say in frequency, we have option of frequency as well. And these are the available for the wave number. So this, it give you the inside like how your refractive index is. So you can see the refractive index graph. And also we can see the reflectivity of this crystal. So this is something. So you can get actually all the optical properties you can calculate in one go, like dielectric constant, susceptibility, polarizability, optical conductivity. So these are the options that has been available. So let's say this is the dielectric constant. So this is the array for the imaginary part as well as the real part. So you can calculate these properties like VC electrical properties. So these are the optical properties as well. So this is the thing here. We can calculate the electrical optical properties, and we can in the plot editor. The thing is that I'm just wanted to set the range. So you can easily see the you can say the visible regions. So we will see how to do that in the plot editor. But first I will show you where we were. So I will show you in the builder. Okay. So in the builder, we see this interface. So now after the interface, there is a lot other functionality as well. So before that, I want to run one more calculations. So because it will take much one time. So in that case, I'm taking the same crystal as I see, and this time I want to calculate the electron density, because old DFT is working over the electron density. So first we have to calculate the electron density, and let's see how electron density look like, or how electron density we will be able to calculate in quantum ATK. So again, you have to add one calculator. You can take any calculator, like even the plane wave as well, some empiricals according to your requirement. There's no problem in that. And then again, I'm going to the analysis part, and I'm selecting electron density. Okay, so this is the option of electron density. Let's see. Okay, so fine. Okay, so I hope you're not getting my screen. Sorry about that. So this is a screen for the script generator. I made a script for calculating the electron density, and I'm going to run it. I'm going to run the calculation. Okay, so I run one more calculation to calculate the electron density, and we will visualize this. We will visualize in viewer. So in the meantime, we will see a few more options that is available. So a lot many options is available here. I will share my screen this time, builder. Okay, so I hope you're getting my screen this time for the builder. We see interface. So after the interface, what other options we have? We have option of making alloy, so we can easily create the alloys as well. And we already see for the surface, how to clean the surface. In the bulk tool, we can already see the repeat option. We have supercell option. We can swap our axis. Okay. And also in the device tool. Okay, so let's see some of the things that is related to the device. So creating a device in quantum ATK is very much easy. So let's suppose this is one gold and silver, and you want to calculate because right now it is a one simple structure. So let's suppose how it behave, like if you add one electrode at the left hand side and add one electrode at the right hand side, and you give some bias, let's say some bias of 2 volt, 3 volt, and in the increasing form. So how the current will flow, something like that. So in that case, you can create the device for this structure as well. You can create device for this structure as well. There's no such problem, because in the device, we just need the electrode. We need the left electrode, right electrode, that's it. So let's see how it look like. So in the device option, there is an option of device from bulk. So if you click on device from bulk, it will give you the left electrode extension length and something right electrode extension length, and you just have to click OK. Okay, so now your carbon nanotubes is converted into the devices. Okay, so in the this left one, it will act as a left electrode, and the right one will be act as a right electrode. So it's act as a drain and source, as we have in the MOSFET or transistors, drain and source. So it is something like that. So, and in quantum ATK, you will be able to perform up to 3 probe devices. Okay, so let's see how to add the third probe. So there is an option of miscellaneous, and there's an option of spatial region here. So if you click on the spatial region, there is an option of plus, and in the plus you can see there is an option of metallic here. So metallic, and it will act as a one point. So you can change the gateway, and this metallic will be act as a drain. So what we have to do, we just have to define our dimension of gate, because sometimes gate you want at the top, sometimes you want gate at the bottom, somewhat very close, sometimes very far, something like that. So accordingly you can define your gate. Okay, you just have to give the dimension. You just have to give the dimensions. We have to give the dimension in A, B, and C, like this. Okay, so you can see very beautifully, you placed one gate around this, and that gate will be of, this is a one block. This is a one block, like box type. So you can also change into a sphere, or in a form of tube, as you have this carbon nanotube. So if you want the gate all around structure, you can also do that. So let's see how to do that. Let this, this is a starting point at zero in X. Okay, fine. This is okay. This is okay. Okay, so accordingly we have to define our, and that you can say dimensions. So I'm quickly giving one some dimensions here. 5. Okay. Fine. So I have to increase the thickness actually, and inner radius as well. So inner radius will be 15. Okay. Or 15 is too much large actually. So it should be 10. Okay. Fine. And the thickness. Thickness is okay. And you have to give some dimensions so that it will be, it will go somewhere else. And it will align. Okay. So accordingly, you can see we can define the gate structure as well. Okay, so this is something like gate all around structure. So we have a geometry of tube, we have geometry of sphere, box, and all those things. You can define according to your requirement. So this is something that, and also I want to show you one more option, that is, let's take this one. And as we already see, we can dope our structure. We can dope our structure. And you can say we can add the vacancy, or we can dope in terms of atoms. But what if we want to dope in terms of electrons? So there is an option of doping here. So what you have to do, you just have to select your atoms. Means, let's say that much of atoms I want to dope, half of the atoms I want to dope. So there is an option of add, and you can define the doping tag and type p-type doping and then value. So accordingly, you can define your doping as well in terms of electrons. Okay. So this is something like a lot more functionality still that available in the things, but I only show you some of the things that will be related to your field might be. And there's an option of Z matrix as well. So this Z matrix will be useful to create the molecule structure. Okay, we already see for the crystals and you can see the device, but we are working on molecules. We can working on the molecules as well. So that Z matrix will be useful in that case. And also we have option of molecular builder as well. So let's suppose any molecules you are working on, you can select, or you can build your own molecules as well. And also import in nanolab like this. Or if you want to find out the interaction of these molecules with the carbon nanotubes in presence of some field, electric field and something like that. So you can also, you also able to do that. So you will be able to work with the molecules. So one last thing, we will see the results for the electron density, and later on we will proceed for the questions. Okay, so let's see, the results is finished. The results is finished for the electron density. Let's see, I want to visualize it. Okay, fine. So as I didn't change the name of the result file, so the electron density result has been added on the same, in the same name SIC. So this is the electron density. Well, let's see how to visualize. So in the option, you have option of text representation as well. So if you are looking for electron density in terms of text, that option is available, but it's not a human readable. Thing is not read of human readable. So in that case, what we can do, we will use the functionality of the viewer. So what you have to do, you just have to select the both the things, like control, press, and then both the things, and then drag and drop to the viewer. So if I drag and drop to the viewer, it will open the viewer, and we will visualize the electron density, how it looks like. So same way, you can also visualize the electron density functions, or that electron locality function and all those things. So this is the drop selection, and okay. And now it's asking what type of plot we want, like cut planes and isosurface. And this time I'm interested to plot isosurface. Okay, so I select the isosurface and make it large. And I will share my screen, I hope. I'm sure you're not getting it. Okay, so I hope you're getting this time. So this is a visualization of viewer here. Okay, this is a visualization of viewer and how you can see the visualization of this isosurface. So we can also change most of the things in the graphics properties. Okay, in the graphics properties, there is an option of isosurface value. Okay, so you can see this much of isosurface means this much of value of electron density available in that much of space, like here and here. You can see, you can visualize like at this area, that much of electron density is available. And you can also change in terms of color map, like hot or rendering, we can render it with lines and all, and normals. Okay, so like this way, if we increase the electron density, you can see it goes inside the atoms, because the most of the electron available, most of the electron density, the probability to finding the electron is inside the atom, and after that it goes above another. If it decreases. And also it takes the effect of other atoms that is available at the in the crystal, because this is only showing the single crystal, but there is other atoms is also available in the left hand side, right hand side, top and above. So it shows you that options as well. Okay, fine. So I think I'm done with my presentation and demonstration part, and we are also short of time. So I want to stop here. So we will take questions. So I'm ready to take questions. If anyone have any doubt, they can ask.
Okay, thank you, Harinji, and letting us know how this ATK works. I'm sure some of the students are ready for their questions. Okay, so we have received number of questions. Okay. So we'll be taking as much as possible. Okay, so first question is from Mr. Anjan Kumar from GLA Mathura, and he's asking, can we model perovskite solar cells using ATK, and are perovskite materials available in the database of ATK?
Okay, yes. So I want to show you. Let's take to the builder. I'm going to the builder. So this is the builder here. And if you go to the plus and in the database, if you can search, Okay, so you can see the perovskite is available. Okay, so this is not the thing. The material is not a problem actually. So you can see the, you can also import the perovskite material. Okay, so material, you can see this is the perovskite. So material is not a problem. If you don't have the any material in the database, so you have one more option that I already told in the beginning. There's an option of database. This is the online database. And I will sharing my screen. I will share it. Okay. So this is the database for the online database. So any material, if that material is not available on the quantum ATK, so you can import, because these are the COD, crystallography open database, and material project. These are the libraries, online libraries that directly interface with the quantum ATK, and you can import any material. Let's suppose if I'm looking for any material that is related to, let's say, carbon and nitrogen. Okay, so you don't have to do anything. You just have to select and carbon and nitrogen and click search button. So it will give you all the whole lot of list of the materials that is available over the internet on this COD library or material project. If you search over the material, all the results, and you can easily import it. Okay, so this is one option, COD, and also you first have to search for the quantum ATK open database, and you already find that perovskite there. I will show you one more time. This window. Fine. So we see we can search for the internet database as well, online database, internet database, and also if you want to define your own crystal, there is a plugins is available which is named as Crystal Builder. So in the Crystal Builder, if you know the space group, if you know the space group of the material, if you know the position of the material, you can define it. You can define, let's suppose if you're looking for any material, hexagonal, and any new material you're working, you just have to define the space group and accordingly their lengths, lattice vectors, and you can define the materials, like at which position. Right now it takes the hydrogen, but for sure we can also change it. You just have to double click, like gallium or germanium, according to your requirement you can do that. Okay, so like this way you can define your new material as well. Like you have three options here. First you have to search for the quantum ATK, then you can go to the online database which is directly related available here, then you can define your own material as well. And also if you go to the from files, there is a lot more extension which is has been supported in quantum ATK. These are the extension like FIC, SAR, XYZ, CARTAP. So these are the options that is available. Okay, so material is not a problem, importing the material, it's not a problem, you can import any material. Now the question is you are you able to simulate quantum perovskite solar cells? You can simulate quantum ATK, you can simulate the perovskite solar cells, but the thing is that what type of field you will apply, as we can already discuss, because what is the dimension of your structure, what is the dimension of your device. If you are still looking for the micro level, or if you are still looking for the the millimeter level or micrometer level, then this is not the right platform actually. If you are looking for the nano level, or you can say up to 10 nanometer, or you can say 100 nanometer, then you can use force field. So according to your requirement, like are you able to use the DFT, are you able to use the force field, or you are looking for the classical potentials, so you will be able to simulate it, but the structure should be in nano level, then you will be able to simulate. Because if you increase the structure, first thing is that the theory will not work, and also you're not able to feel, like practically you are not able to provide the resources that has been asked by the software to simulate a very big solar cells. So if you have the nano level solar cell, because one paper is already been published, One paper is already been published. I will share the link to the sir and he will share to the other members as well. So one paper has been published and they published, they that has been published on the solar cells, and they only predict the one properties, something related to the interface, only the interface part they did, not the complete solar cells. So something like that, if you are looking for only for the interface, or if you are looking for only for up to the some to up to, so you can say up to some levels, like you can say the nano level or something like that, then you will be able to simulate it, but not a big solar cells. That we have different software for the that known as the TCAD simulator tool for the device at, you can say, the micro level or millimeter level. So right. I hope you get the answer.
Right.
For the materials, for the material, there is no problem. You can import any material and you can simulate any material properties. Okay. So but for the device, there is a problem with the dimensions. Yes, sir. Sorry.
Right. Similar question was available from Piyush and other participants. I hope you have already answered. Another question is from Neeraj Kulhari, and he is asking, is it an open source software?
No, actually, it's not an open source software. It is a commercial software. And it is a part of Synopsys website, Synopsys group. And it's not a open source, but we provide the 30 days trial lessons. If you're interested, you can apply to the trial lessons. And as you can see that it is a lot more functionality and lot many things we are providing here, like we are providing DFT LCO, DFT plate waves, semi empiricals, force fields, and not many things is here. So it's not an open source, actually, it's a commercial software, but you can try for 30 days trial. You can apply for 30 day trial. That's a complete free.
Okay. The next question is from Dheeraj Kumar, and he's asking, can we calculate dielectric constant using this?
Yeah, dielectric constant, I hope I already show in optical properties, actually. If you can see, I will show you one more time. I will show you one more time. Okay, so in the optical spectrum, you can see, if you can check. Fine. So in the optical spectrum, yes, we can calculate the dielectric. So the absorption, you can see the dielectric constant is here. In the real part as well as the image. So dielectric properties, yes, you can, for the material, you can calculate lot many properties for the dielectric, optical or mechanical, thermal, or molecular dynamics can also be performed here, but because of shortage of time, I'm not able to. But molecular dynamics can also be, you know, like NPT in samples or NPT, if your people are working on the molecular dynamics. So yes, we can do that as well. Does Cortometry support the molecular dynamics as well?
Next question is, are these tools applicable for metal oxide structures?
Yes. Metal oxide structures, yes, that is available. I will see one example. Okay. Let's share my screen for one more time for the builder. Okay, in the builder. Okay, this is the builder. And if you can go to the plus and plugins, so there is a magnetic tunnel junction. Okay, so this is the magnetic tunnel junction. You will be able to simulate such a structure as well. Okay, so this is the magnetic tunnel junction. It has the MGU. And this is the iron. So you will be able to create magnetic tunnel junctions as well.
Okay. The next question is from K. Vinod Kumar, and he's asking, can we import file formats such as CIF to use the structures and calculate photo color?
Right. So I hope I just showed that just now. So there is an option of from files available. So in the from files, load many extensions available. Like you can see, the card CASTP is available, XYZ, CAR, CIF, FHI, AIMS. So load many extensions. The widely used is CIF and XYZ. So yes, they are supported. And you can easily import.
Okay. Now, another question is Jyoti, and she wanted to ask, do we need to learn any language for using this ATK?
No, because as you can, you already see, I didn't use any Python. I didn't write any code here. I just use graphical user interface. This is a very sophisticated tool, you can say. You just have to go search, select the material, double click and single click, and your job has been done. You don't have to learn any language. There is no problem in that. But if you know the language, it's a plus point there. Sometime it will be helpful. That's the only thing. But it's not a limitation. You can do all the things. All the graphical user interface.
Okay. Next question is from Mr. Sanoth Kumar, and he's asking, can you please again share us what is the difference between ATK and virtual nano lab? Because we are using these two words.
Okay. ATK and virtual nano lab. Okay. So there's a only difference is that these are, you can say, this our software is quantum ATK, and our software have, you can say, as simple as that, the software has two part. One is VNL and second is ATK. Okay, so VNL and ATK, as every software have, so this software is also have two part, VNL, ATK. You can term it as a front end and the back end of the software. So front end of the software is the VNL, virtual nano lab, and the back end of the software is the ATK. ATK, which performs the calculations, and VNL, where you will do your modeling and visualize the results. Okay. So I hope this is clear the doubt.
Right. Now, another question is from Ankita Pandian. She's asking, is there any unexpected error encountered in ATK during its use?
During execution? Okay, yes. So sometimes yes, because it's also a code, or you can say, because sometimes it, because of the, you can say that because of the human problems, or you can say sometimes because of the hardware problem, sometimes yes, we face. But in the ATK, as I already show before, let's show you one more time. There is a job manager. Okay, so in the job manager, so everything is written here, everything, because if you're running your calculation, everything is written here. If you face any problem, if you face any error, it will give you the exact description of that, why you're facing this, how to resolve that. And accordingly, you can proceed for the, you can proceed for the solution. Because of the human, you will, for sure, you will get some time error, and because of the hardware, because most of the time hardware, because sometimes, because you run your some calculations, and there is a problem sometimes happen between the because you made one script and you're not able to provide the proper resources. So sometimes, yes, you face some error, but it's not a problem that you're not able to resolve it. It's a simple description. You will get the proper description of that, and you can proceed to the resolve, and it's very easy to resolve the, you can say the easy to resolve error. So it's not a much problem.
The next question is from Mr. Sachin Patak, and he's asking, what kind of specification do we need in our computer for using this software?
Specification for installing the software, you need, let's say, for installing the software, because I'm also using in my laptop. So it has 4 cores and 4 GB of RAM. So installation, it's not a problem. The problem is that, or because some, the time we run our calculations. Okay, you can see, I run my calculation like electron density, band structure, optical spectrum. It takes like 5 minutes, 3 minutes. So according to the resources I'm providing, if you have the better performing cluster, or if you have a better performing workstation, then you will be able to get your results faster. So it's like a trade-off between your, you can say the trade-off between your time and you can say computing the time to, and computation process. But sometimes it happens, you run your plane wave calculation, and they demand more memory. So it totally depends on your structure. For if you're working on the material calculation, I will suggest you like 16 GB of RAM and 8 cores will be sufficient. And if you're working on the devices, you can make it double or something like that. So it totally depends on your structure and what type of calculation you want to perform. Is something like that. So okay. It's like you have to make an optimum choice between time, resources, accuracy. So it is something like that. You have to make an optimum choice between all those three.
And most importantly, I guess, the available funds.
All right. Okay. Available funds.
Okay. The next question is from Dr. Arun Manotra, and he's asking how we can get this ATK.
How we can get? Actually, for the ATK, we are the authorized distributor in India. So you can contact us. I will share my details. I will, because we are done with the presentation. We are done with the demonstration part. So our part has been done here. Live demonstration has been done. So now this is our integrated microsystem. This is our office address. We are based on Gurgaon. And this is our website, www.ims-india.org. And we have other tools as well. We are authorized distributor of this Synopsys, this tool, and also other software of Synopsys, as well as the other groups as well. like cross-sites at other TCAD simulation tool as well, or 3D mesh segmentation tool. So this is our address and this is a website. Or for more information, you can get there. Or you can contact us directly. Like this is my mail ID, harinder@imus-india.org, and this is my number. So you can contact us directly and we will provide you the quantum mechanical software.
Okay. The next question is from Mr. Rajesh Niranjan, and he's asking, can we have a structure deformation picture from experimental data feeding into the software as obtained experimental samples data? Normally does not come to expect it from simulations.
Okay, means you, because that person have some data and he want to fill that data in the software.
Right.
Means in which format that data is available? Means in which format? The first question is that. Okay, fine. So as I saw, there's an option of import option. If you can see that I show in Quantumatic Builder. Okay. Wait. So this is a builder here. Okay, so this is a builder here. If you can click on the plus button. So these are the options that is available to import a structure. So we can see the from files database. So we only have option to import the structure. We don't have any option to import the calculated data, because I think that they calculated something over the experiment and they want to import that thing here. So is it something, because is it the question like he performed one experiment and get some data?
Yes, because no format of data is mentioned, so I guess it may be clear. Okay.
Yes.
Then let's take another question from Dr. Sachin Pathak, and he's asking, on what basis how we can define K points in the structure such as C and T's for calculation of planned structure?
Okay. For the K points, it totally depends like size of your structure, as I told in demonstration part as well, because K points has either it's like a sampling. Let's suppose you have one cube and you want to sample that cube to find out like properties, because if let's suppose you have one cube and in A, B and C direction, if you sample it, you will get node points. You will get node points in space, and at each every node point, it will calculate the property. It will calculate the density, electron density. Okay, at each node point. So same way it will work like that, but in this case, it will sample the reciprocal space, not the real space. So if you increase the size, you increase the size of carbon nanotube. So means you have one larger size in C direction. Let's suppose you have A, B, C direction. You have A 10 armstrong, B 10 armstrong, and C you have 100 armstrong. So you first have to convert that thing into a reciprocal space. So it will be 1 by 10, 1 by 10, and 1 by 100. So accordingly, you have to define your K points. Let's suppose you define 10, 10, 1 or 10, 10, 2. And how to define is like, it's something like that. You have to perform a conversion test. So let's suppose you perform one calculation, let's say 5, 5, and 1, 5, 5, because we have C is lengthy. So I'm taking K points as a 1. So let's suppose you perform one calculation 5, 5, 1, and you get some, let's suppose for this, I calculate the total energy. So this is how we do the convergence change. We calculate the total energy and get some value. Okay, let's suppose I get some value X. And again, I increase some K points, let's say 7, 7, 1, and I get one more value. This should be X plus delta X, right? So in that case, you can see you have to perform your calculation one by one until you will not reach the saturation value that is, you can say, acceptable by us, because it totally depends on us. Like, are you acceptable? Did you accept that results that you are getting? Because sometimes people they're not able tolerate, they do not able accept the single, you can say, even up to 0.0001 level of difference or something like that. So it totally depends on us. So we have to perform different values of K points. We have to perform our conversion test and we have to find out the saturation value. And that if we get the saturation value at that point, we can perform our calculation for different analysis, like say band structure, DOS, and all those things. So basically, we perform over the total energy for the materials and transmission spectrum for the devices. This is the thing, actually.
Right.
So I hope I answer.
I guess. So participants, again, I am saying for selecting proper K value is a kind of, you can say, tricky task, and you may have to perform a number of test calculations. Okay. And this you may learn by your experience once you start calculating using DFT. Okay. And the selection of K point also depends on the dimensionality of the structure. Maybe you are dealing with 1D structures or 2D structures or 3D structures, then they all demand different set of selected K points. Okay. So there is no one thumb rule that you may select this K points for all your calculations. Okay. So our next question is from Sarvesh Kumar Gupta, and he's asking, is it useful to study ionic conductivity and ion transfer number of the electrodes used for batteries using ATK?
Okay.
Interested in calculating ionic conductivity. Yes, for batteries.
Okay. So for the, he want to calculate for the batteries, he want to calculate ionic transfer.
Yes.
Okay. So for actually, I can't say totally 100% it is available or not. Okay. So in the analysis part, maybe there is some workaround is available, but not directly you can't perform. As I already told you that there is not many options that you can perform directly, but there is some indirectly options is also available. So you will be able to perform for that. I have to make sure first, because I have to work over it. I have to check it if it is available, and then I will answer that.
No, it's not directly available. It's not directly available, Arinji.
Okay, if it's not directly available, then if there is a workaround available, then I will tell you. Okay. Right. But I can't answer this question right now, actually.
It's not directly available. Okay. So next question is from Bhanu Priya, and she's asking, is DFT helpful in sensing application of thin films of inorganic compounds?
For the sensing application.
Right.
Yes, you can do that. For the sensing application, there is a lot, many papers has been published in quantum, with the quantum wise, like sensor, like nanotube sensor or gas sensors. So same principle can be applied on thin films as well. Like you can take up one thin film, and you can, like for the sensors, you can place one gas or any molecules, and you can see, check that how it affect the properties, how it affect the, you can say, the transmission spectrum, how it affect the IV or something like that. You can create, like if one molecule is close to that, then how it affect the properties of that, how it affect the characteristic of that material or device. So yes, sensing application can be done. The paper has been published. It will be better if you can look that, and so that you will get your answer and you can relate, because for the carbon nanotube, it is available. One paper has been published. So same principle can be applied on with the thin film as well.
Yes. Participants can also explore the website of Synopsys.
Oh, yeah. That will be better.
And yes. There are a number of scientific papers available, which is published by using this quantum ATK. I think that would be much better. Okay. And next question is from Niharika Chaurasia, and she's asking, is it possible to study supercapacitance of electrode materials using this quantum ATK and for the study of electrochemical sensors?
I think yes, one tutorial available. If the person will go to the website, they have to search the capacitor on the website, tutorial website. So one complete tutorial is available. So I hope she will get her answer there
One last question. Oh, we are taking one from question, and it is from Mohammed Zafar, and he is asking, where can we get installation demo of quantum ATK?
Trial version, right?
Or how we can install it? Yes, demo. How we can install?
Actually, we provide that because we provide the 30 days trial lessons that is free, and we provide that. And for that, they have to go to the website, and on the website, I will share one more time to. Okay, fine. So people can search, or they can scan this, so they can directly go to the website. Okay. Okay, so they can scan or they can search Quantum ATK, and there is an option of evaluation as well. So they can go and apply, and their evaluation will be, you can say, verified or approved within 3 days or 4 days or in a week according to the situations. So this is the thing, they have to go to the website for the papers, the tutorials, everything. Lot more data is available on the website. It's always better if they go to the website and explore the things to get their answer.
Okay. So I think that's all for now. And let's thank to the speaker, Mr. Harins from Integrated Microstate Systems. And now I back to Dr. Atharia for further processing. Dr. Jaiswal, please.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Jaiswal, for nicely conducting the session. And I thank the speaker once again for his nice presentation. We have got some good comments from the participants, and I hope they will be certainly trying to use your software. So we have, it's for the participants, we have another session starting tomorrow, 11 o'clock. So we'll meet then. And for now, it's goodbye from us. See you.